It's the SEC on ESPN, and we are indeed at the Odo, Gainesville, Florida. Rivalry week presented by Cisco continues. Non-conference matchup today. The Musketeers of Xavier who are trying to inch to the top spot with Richmond in the A-10 standings and trying to improve their resume. Likewise, the Florida Gators trying to do the same thing with Kentucky on top, playing Tennessee later on tonight on ESPN. Vanderbilt's already been a winner today. Florida trying to get their seventh win in conference play. Welcome to Gainesville, everybody. Brad Nessler with Jimmy Dykes. This is odd, Jimmy. 7 years have passed since Florida's played a non-league game at this time of year. But it's a key game for both these teams. You don't want to lose this one right now.
No, not at all. Both these teams are tracking to be in the NCAA tournament right now. Xavier tracking to be about an 8 seed. Florida tracking to be about a 9 seed. So this is like a first-round ball game. It's just not on a neutral floor. Of major importance to both Xavier and Florida. Florida, Brad, nothing jumps out at a selection committee more than a mid-February out-of-conference high-quality win. That is what is at stake in this ball game.
All right, let's take a look at our star watch in this one. Jordan Crawford, the leading scorer in the A-10 at almost 20 points a game. And Chandler Parsons has become Mr. Versatility, Jimmy, for Florida.
Parsons back-to-back double-doubles in points and rebounds. He's also thrown in 6 assists per ball game over the last two.
Joe Lindsay, Roger Ayers, Tim Flockerty, our officials. Set to jump center with Janelle McLean. And it'll be Xavier on Florida's home floor with the first possession.
Man-to-man defense by Florida. They will mix man and zone in this ball game. Full court pressure as well.
Nice move by Jason Love with a left-handed hook shot.
Brad, he's a pretty good load. 6'9", 265 pounds. Can score with either paw around the rim.
Let's see how Florida's interior plays with Macklin and Tyus. There's Macklin. That's a pretty good start. He's going to go to the free throw line. Different starting lineup for Florida today. Dan Werner starts instead of Irving Walker because Irving was late to one of Billy Donovan's team meetings. And thus, he'll play. But he's sitting over there on the bench right now.
You know what? I think it's interesting. With Dan Werner struggling so much in conference play, getting a start, is this the kind of momentum that Dan Werner might build off of and get his offense going? Different role for Walker today, a different role for Werner.
Werner, one of the captains, of course, and in past years has been a tremendous outside threat as a three-point shooter and just hasn't been there lately for him. Wasn't there for Vernon Macklin from the free throw line either. Missed him both.
Brad, Xavier's been off for a full week after being pounded by Dayton 90-65. Their defense really let him down. They've always scored well.
Yeah, they got pounded. They beat Dayton earlier in the season, so they split with them. They've got some quality wins over Cincinnati and Charlotte. They had a double overtime loss to Wake Forest, which is really a heartbreaker for them. But as you said, if they could pick off Florida on the Gators' home floor with their 11-2 this year, that would be a nice looking spot on the resume.
They really lack that true road win that jumps out at you from their portfolio.
Here's a touch foul on Dante Jackson.
Chandler Parsons for Florida has really been hot the last couple of ball games. You like a guy in mid-February that has a confident, cocky kind of a strut about him.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what Parsons has going right now.
Here he is on the inbound, and there goes the basket Jimmy's talking about. He heard you.
He's very active. He has lively legs. So important for teams to gain their second win in the middle of February. And Parsons right now has his.
Wow. Up and under. What a scoop shot. It didn't go, but it's tipped in by Love. That shows you Jordan Crawford's athleticism. Even though he missed the shot, Love cleans up for him.
Chandler Parsons, I talked about him being active and alert, high energy. Just the last 10 days for Florida, they use him to just curl off of a simple out-of-bounds play. You see more scoring off of an out-of-bounds play when you step out of conference in February than any other time.
Not used to each other.
Not at all.
Don't see each other twice a year.
Nope.
In the corner, three-pointer is almost an air ball. Tyus had his hands on it, but he lost it out of bounds. Chris Mack, his first year as the head coach, two-time captain as a player at Xavier. Spent 3 years as a player under Pete Gillen and then was an assistant with Skip Prosser at Wake Forest and Xavier and Sean Miller most recently in the last 5 years before becoming the head coach.
Brad, he is intensely loyal to Xavier, a great hire, and they just keep that string of coaches going. Gillen, Prosser, Thad Mata, Miller, and now it's Chris Mack's turn.
He's a native, high school there, and the whole shebang. Here's a rebound by Parsons and on the run. The big guy can dribble and drive. 6'9", handles it like that and takes it to the rack to tie the game.
He has actually given rest to Irving Walker and Boynton at that point guard position. As versatile a player in the SEC as you'll find right now.
McLean cut off by Macklin and now fouled by Macklin.
Chandler Parsons, Brad, is not a jet in the open floor, but he has good control of the basketball, and his length, once he gets 1 foot in the lane, his length actually makes him quicker because he can get to that rim with those long arms.
Jimmy, I talked to him before the game. I said, I kind of like you in that point guard position. He said, you know what? I was only 6'1 as a freshman in high school, Mr. Nessler, so I got a little point guard blood in me, but then I sprouted up to 6'8 and 6'9.
I like that. I like the fact he refers to you as Mr. Nessler.
I do, too.
Earlier today, he said, hey, Jimmy, to me.
Boy. The harder I try, the more I just fall back in your shadows.
I tell you what, you'll get older. Don't worry. It happens. Musketeers by one.
See, there's Parsons giving Boynton and Walker some rest, bringing that ball up.
So even though he's listed at 6'9", it's really a three-guard offense out there right now at Parsons. And Boynton's foul from three-point land by Jackson. And that's his second foul.
Unusual play out of Jackson, Brad. He's their best perimeter defender. Always on the other team's hot shooter. And he's a upperclassman that should understand you do not fly out of a control at a three-point shot.
Kenny Boynton. The freshman out of Pompano Beach, Florida, he's been struggling a little bit lately. I don't know if it's the freshman wall that he's hit or the competition's just gotten better, but he's still Florida's leading scorer overall. Averaging 14 a game.
He and Walker both have struggled from the three-point line the last four ball games. Boynton 6 out of 27, Walker 6 out of 22.
Got 2 out of 3. So Florida in front. And again, full court pressure. And the Musketeers are having some trouble with it right now. They get it ahead to Holloway. Crawford, nice pass inside to Love. Boy, he put some smoke on that one.
Brad, absolutely no lag time from the time Xavier broke the press to they got into the zone offense. That's as good as you can do it.
Here's Walker drawing a double team. Tyus outside. And the Musketeers looking to run all the way with Crawford.
He's a shot maker, isn't he?
Some guys just know how to score. Yes. He's one of them.
He is one of them.
Certainly got to be considered for A-10 Player of the Year. Averaging just under 20 a game. Alex Tyus trying to back in, goes baseline. Nice shot off the glass. Gators aren't going to give up on the full court heat, are they? They might have to if this keeps happening, though. Either that or somebody's got to get back. Love's got 8 of the Musketeers' 11.
Or Xavier's so good at breaking the initial trap. And then once they get the ball to the timeline, it is full bore down on the rim.
So far for Xavier, it looks like the week off, the rests, and the look back at what happened to him last Saturday, they don't want it to happen again. Playing very well on the road here early.
2-3 zone by Florida, and Xavier, a team that likes to overload where your weakness is. Only two guys up top, they have 3 around the free throw area. There you go to work.
McLean buries it from just inside the free throw line.
2-point advantage. Just over 5 minutes in. Tyus had it stripped as he went up. And he lost it out of bounds. So Florida turns it over.
Right now, Musketeers. There's two Musketeers right there.
Can I say?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Cisco. Welcome to the Human Network and the all-new 2010 SRX, the Cadillac of crossovers.
Outside the O-Dome in Gainesville.
Rivalry week presented by Cisco and Xavier all over Florida here in the early going as Jimmy takes us inside the play.
Brad, I mentioned no lag time by Xavier between their transition offense and their half-court offense. Keep an eye on the shot clock right now. Now, at this point, the transition offense is over. Now the half-court offense begins. Watch how quickly they get organized, and the shot gets off. As you run it forward, transition offense is over. Now the half-court offense is on. They get organized. They blitz that Florida zone. So from 20 seconds to 24 seconds, no lag time. Great, great execution by Xavier.
10 points in the paint already for Xavier at a 5-point lead. Florida's going to stick with the full court pressure. Xavier has been breaking it and getting easy buckets. Let's see if they do again. Holloway inside to Frease. He hit the bottom of the rim, but he's fouled by Eric Murphy.
So far, advantage Xavier in the full court pressing situation.
You got that right. But Kenny Frease, big kid out of Massillon, Ohio, at the free throw line. There he's 20 of 40. On the year, 50%. Knock that one down.
Brad, this kid's a 7-footer, weighs 265. Kenny Frease at the free throw stripe. But he plays small on film. He doesn't go through the defense. He kind of plays small and gets his shoulders down too low. A highly recruited guy. Notre Dame, Michigan, Kentucky all wanted this kid. And he needs a great offseason prior to his next year.
Dr. Ron Blackledge, Todd's dad, who's here at the game, and he gave me the scouting report on Kenny Frease because he's Kenny's mom's godfather.
How about that?
And he said he's got to hit the offensive boards better, so I'm going with an old coach.
Yeah, play bigger.
Oh, Dan Werner got smacked as he crossed the lane. I could hear it over here, and no foul. Here's Frease on the break, and he's going to go back to the free throw line.
You saw a glimpse right there of why Kenny Frease was so highly recruited and thought of out of high school. I mean, that is a big load of a man to run rim to rim and keep up with guard speed.
The Rowdy Reptiles behind us are screaming, "Didn't you hear the slap on the other end on Werner?" As we could hear it over here. Sound like one of those WWE jobs where you wrap the guy in the chest really loud.
Wow.
Xavier so alert, so active, lively legs early to start this game. Again, they've been off for a week.
And they build a big early lead on Florida. Irving Walker with a pull-up, hit the back of the iron. Frease will clear the glass. Mark Lyons on the dribble. Jump stop, then wraps it around underneath. And Love is having himself a time. Billy Donovan's not in love with what he's seeing from his Gators, I can tell you that right now. 19-8. The big fella's already got 10 for the Musketeers. Now, right now, Xavier on a 15-4 run, and they lead 19-8 on the O-Dome floor, where Florida's 11-2 this year. And Xavier, the fresh team. Temple won its 20th game today, 20-5, and you look at the 8-10, Jimmy, that's a strong group.
Well, you're dealing with a Xavier squad that's tied for first right now in the A-10 with Charlotte and Richmond. The A-10 right now tracking to have six teams in the NCAA tournament. That's more than the SEC at this point.
Right. And even the most realistic of people would say at least four, right?
Sure.
I mean, you can stretch it to six, or maybe you're right, but right now they're playing this group like they're definitely going to be invited. Chandler Parsons is the one guy that's playing well for Florida in the early going and comes up with a steal.
Look at that ball pressure up top, huh? Just absolutely chewing up Irving Walker.
Walker waiting for Parsons to come around a pick. Jumper clanged off the front of the rim. Crawford saves it in the corner. Brad Redford is a great three-point shooter in the lineup. Here's Crawford on a fadeaway jumper. Nice shot.
About as good a start as you could ask for if you're Xavier on the road against Florida.
This might be as good a start as we've seen anybody have. Tyus with a left hand. Macklin tried to help out. Ball out of bounds to Florida.
Jordan Crawford, Brad, takes 15 shots a game, and he has a very good balance to his game. He'll take 5 threes, 10 twos, and he gets to the free throw stripe 8 times per ball game. Have to honest guard a guy like that.
That was pretty good defense by Parsons, but with that fadeaway shot, he got it up over his outstretched arms. Florida's going to have another chance. And going for the steal was Crawford, and instead he ends up with a foul. Don't forget a big SEC matchup coming up tonight. College hoops prime time. Number 12 Tennessee, number 2 Kentucky will get together Saturday prime time, presented by DirecTV, part of Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco. 9 o'clock Eastern time. It follows us and Game Day. I heard they had a nice crowd at Game Day today, huh?
A record crowd, 22,000 plus.
Wow. And a foul on the rebound will be on Kenny Frease. 21-10, Billy Donovan is going to talk with us in our SEC Spotlight about what Dad meant to him growing up and the coach that he's become. Billy Donovan's dad, Bill, in attendance, could run for mayor in probably any city that he goes to. And in our SEC Spotlight, his son talked about the influence his dad had on him as a person, a player, and a coach.
He always was pushing me to get better, but he wasn't somebody that dragged me to the gym. Let's go. We got to go work out. Or you got to go do this. He always put it out there of, you know, what do you want to do with your life? You know, what do you want to do? And, you know, it's up to you.
He is truly dedicated to his family. He really cares deeply about his family. And I think the second thing is, when it comes to work, he really has a tremendous work ethic. I mean, he just gives it his all, 100%, all the time. And I think the third thing that I would say is that he really and truly has no ego. And he treats everybody equally and goes out of his way to help anybody he can. And that's kind of the three traits that I admire most about him.
And if you knew Mr. D as Jimmy and I do, you'd know that he's a chip off the old block, pretty much.
Yeah, he pretty much also described himself, didn't he?
That's what I was going to say.
You're exactly right, partner. But what a great time for a father and a son. Father travels with the Gators when they're on the road, and just memories that they will always have with him. Beautiful story.
Yeah, pretty special. Walker for three. Got it. Irving Walker, not a starter today, but starting to warm up maybe a little bit for the Gators.
Brett Xavier, a very good passing team in their motion offense. They get one assist for every two baskets, and they're on that rate in this ballgame so far.
Down to 14 on the shot clock. Holloway on the drive, trying to go over Macklin, and out of bounds to Florida. Holloway, the leading assist man for the Musketeers, and the number one free throw shooter in the A-10. That's a good combination in the backcourt, a guy that scores 20 a game and a guard that shoots better than anybody else from the free throw line.
Xavier taking away the set play calls of Florida so far in this game, forcing Florida to go to the quick motion.
10 on the shot clock. Tyus trying to lob it to Macklin. There's going to be a push from behind on Frease. That'll be his second foul. And so Frease will sit down. McLean comes back in. Florida down 8 as we're almost at the midway point of the first half already.
Florida now, and the next team foul by Xavier will be in the 1-1. So they're getting there at a pretty good time with 10 minutes to go in the first half.
Irving Walker thought he was going to have a free three. Parsons will. Crawford on the rebound and the run. Holloway leaves it for Love. 12 for Jason Love, which is over his average. And we still got 10 minutes to play in the first half.
But again, great passing of the basketball by Xavier right now. I mean, they really move and share. You hear Chris Mack on the sidelines, move, move, move. Most important word when you're using a passing game motion offense.
Tyus. The outside jump shots for Florida are making noise on the rim. That's not a good sign. And then it's run and ripped the other way for McLean again. 12-point lead. Biggest of the night.
Now, there's a reason why Xavier, Butler, Gonzaga are the power teams out of the, from without the Power Six Conference. They schedule up. They have elite players and terrific coaching in all three of those programs. What I'm talking about, they drive that basketball, and a good job of the big to run right down and gut cut to the rim on a drive and a dish opportunity.
Jason Love is eating up Macklin and Tyus inside right now. Neither's been able to handle it. For the most part, it's been Macklin's responsibility. Here's Love with Macklin on his hip. Redford for three. Rims it out. Love's got the rebound. Crawford now gets a pick. Pick and roll to Love. Great pass. Missed the shot, though. Second chance. They won't miss that one. McLean inside.
It is men against boys around that rim early in this ball game.
Boy, is it ever.
And the visitors in the dark blue are the men.
The O'Connell Center crowd is stunned, I can tell you that right now. Parsons going to go to the free throw line. Reminder, Rivalry Week presented by Cisco continues 1 o'clock tomorrow. Third-ranked Syracuse at home at Carrier Dome against Louisville. If you haven't seen Syracuse play, they are one of the best in the game.
And again, if I had to just pay to get in to watch any game right now on a neutral floor, it would be Kansas versus Syracuse. I think those are the two destined to play in that national title game.
They're both playing like it right now, that's for sure. Florida's playing like they're not going to get invited if they don't wake up here down 14. Parsons has five to lead the way for Florida. Again, a little two-man pressure in the backcourt from Shipman and Walker.
You know, Brad, when you get it handed to you, like Xavier did last Saturday against Dayton, you have a week off of practice, you find out about your team. And Chris Mack told me earlier today, I will find out if the 5 days of practice have paid off or not early in this game. I think he has his answer.
He sure does. And Love has given him even more of an answer. 14 for the big fella. They got smacked on the boards, 242-24 by Dayton last week, and they only shot 38%. And today they're dominating on the board, and they're not missing many shots. Of course, half of them have been slam dunks. It's kind of hard to miss those.
That is the formula to win on the road. When you can control the prime real estate, that 6 to 8 foot radius around the rim, and that's exactly what Jason Love is doing. He loves playing in Gainesville.
Here in Gainesville, 29-14. And when it's Valentine's weekend, you got to know a guy named Love's going to have a big game.
Yeah,
he's got 14 already.
Should have known, huh?
Yep. Too bad we don't have Ted Valentine as one of our officials.
Saw him Thursday night in Starkville.
That's just the beginning of Valentine's weekend for you. Irving Walker, 4 points. Averaging over 13 a game. Sophomore out of Brooklyn. Got a boat.
Brad, the prime real estate in any basketball game is in that paint right around the rim. And Xavier with 20 of their 29 points in the paint in this game so far.
And Irving Walker with the foul. Well, so far it has been a love fest.
And Brad, Jason Love is not an above-the-rim guy. He's a below-the-rim, powerful player that is really benefiting off the driving ability of Xavier's guards. Look how many easy baskets he's gotten because his hands are in catch position off of a drive.
He's got 14. The rest of the team, 15. Lions trying to work his way around Walker. Florida trying to pick up its intensity on defense. Got an open man, though, on the far wing, and the three goes for Dante Jackson. Lead goes to 16.
That's why you don't want to fall behind against Xavier, because you try to go to a zone, and they can really stroke it from you. Everything going Xavier's way early.
There's a nice offensive rebound by freshman Eric Murphy. Got his man in the air. He'll drive into traffic and pay the price for it. Offensive foul. Nice job by Shipman to hold his ground.
Lions out of control. The reason why he chose to drive over the jump shot, he's shooting 18% from the three-point line in conference play. So he doesn't have the confidence in his stroke. And that time he took the ball one dribble too deep.
Walker threw a double team. Murphy baseline, got it. Back-to-back baskets by Eric Murphy. Holloway will go to the free throw line.
You talk about a team in attack mode so far at Xavier. That time the shot got up after a make by Florida with 30 seconds left on the shot clock. So Chris Mack has come into this building with his kids on edge right now. And Florida's not sprinting, Brad, the defense and getting it set.
Vernon Macklin coming back in. Murphy will get a breather. Did a nice job in his spot duty with back-to-back baskets for Florida. Parsons comes back in and Shipman will sit out. Problem for Florida, they sent, as I said, the number one foul shooter in the A-10 to the stripe. 86% free throw shooter. And he sort of coaxed that one in. Walker looked to Macklin. He was open for just a split second. And now he splits through the defenders, but it's an offensive foul.
That is big-time man-to-man defense by Xavier. And it looked like the defender was still moving from that replay, sliding in, because Walker had already left the floor and the defender wasn't set. And I think Xavier gets a break.
Xavier with good ball handlers. The pressure has not affected them in the least. At least not so far.
And Brad, Xavier's doing this now without a big first half from Jordan Crawford.
He's going to go deep and miss the three, and Tyus will clear it off for Florida. Kenny Boynton trying to push the attack. Parsons pull up three. Florida's three-point shooting hasn't been good all year, and it's not any better today. Florida's 11th in the 12-team SEC in three-point percentage. And they're showing why today so far.
They've been inconsistent, Walker and Boynton.
are the two guys that launch the most, and they have been struggling over the last four ball games, both of them in that 20% range.
Probably the best news the Gators just got is Crawford is guilty of that foul. That's two on him, two on Dante Jackson, two on Love, and two on Freeze. So a little bit of concern for the Musketeers as far as fouls. Macklin's missed all three of his free throw attempts. Wow, that was really a miss.
Just giving away points right there.
Yeah.
Absolutely just giving them away.
Florida's 5 of 11 from the stripe. So if you're not hitting the threes and you're not shooting free throws, you better find some inside work, and that hasn't been happening for them either.
Nope.
Under 5 minutes now and a half. A half dominated by Xavier. Boynton got a two-on-one, and he's fouled before he got the pass away. And that one will go on Jackson, and that'll be his third.
Kenny Boynton Jr., a freshman, just made a senior play.
I like that.
Because the defender has not established himself, and he keeps moving. So Boynton drives it right at the number 25 and forces his way to the free throw stripe.
So that'll do it for Jackson, I would assume, for this half. There, he's going to walk over the bench now as Redford will come back in for him. Boynton hits the free throw. As you mentioned, Kenny is junior. Kenny Sr. was a star at Bethune-Cookman. His grandpa was an All-American at FAMU. So he's got great basketball bloodlines. Kenny Boynton, the freshman, 4 for 5 from the free throw line for all his scoring. And the lead is sliced to a dozen.
With foul trouble on the bench for Xavier, an important four closing minutes out of Florida. Can they make hay right now?
They tried that quick pass into the middle. This time was almost intercepted. He gets some heat on his passes. Redford missed a three. Freeze is there in the right spot and puts it in for his first field goal.
Maybe as good a first half from Freeze in the last month. He's been very active around that rim.
Parsons tried a drop pass that was picked off, trying to get it to Tyus, and now Crawford runs and slams. Boy, and how quick did he get down the floor? Comes up with a steal and ends it with a flush on the other end.
I said at the top of the broadcast, this is like an 8 versus 9 first round NCAA tournament game. Looking more like a 6 versus 11.
Parsons in some traffic, goes up with a left hand, had it deflected, comes to Macklin, and he'll drop a hook shot inside. Florida needs more of that out of Vernon Macklin and Alex Tyus.
Brad, Florida in the first half, they have to have learned a lesson. You cannot play finesse basketball against Xavier around the rim. You better fight for your drives, and you better fight for your points against this guy's coach team. Chris Mack is, you know, I asked him earlier today, what is your stamp on this team as a first-year head coach? He said, my stamp is to keep the same stamp in place. Because he comes through that same coaching tree of Skip Prosser and Thad Mott and Sean Miller and all the success over the years that runs to the Elite Eight in 04 and 08. No reason to change anything.
Right.
That's a wise move by first-year head coach.
Two Elite Eights and a Sweet 16 in the last 6 years, so they know what they're doing in Xavier. And they have a 14-point lead right now with 3:16 remaining in the first half. Don't forget, coming up tonight, SEC, Tennessee and Kentucky. There's the 8-10. Temple now with a win today. They go to 20-5. You see the RPI, all those teams in the top 45 in the RPI.
That is the strongest league this year, and in most cases, they're right there outside of the Power 6 conferences. And the reason why those clubs are so good with those RPIs, Charlotte, Richmond, Xavier, Temple, Rhode Island, Brad, they schedule. They schedule out of conference now. They take you on.
They're taking Florida on, and they're putting it on the Gators right now. Tyus had his hands on the rebound. Going to try to hustle for it, but he can't get there. Jordan Crawford, 6 points in the first half, running the floor beautifully. 38-24.
can really ball.
And then game day. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV. All part of Rivalry Week presented by Cisco Volunteers. And the Wildcats tonight at 9 on ESPN. Brad Nessler, Jimmy Dykes, and our ESPN crew here in a non-conference tilt between Florida, the SEC, and Xavier, the A-10. And right now it is all A-10. They dominated from the get-go. Florida's only lead was at 6-5, and that was just over 3 minutes into the game. Tyus, again, had his hands on a rebound and lost it. And the loose balls go for the Musketeers. Holloway. It'll be a foul on Shipman trying to get position for that rebound. Oh, maybe not. We're going to call it on Parsons instead.
Fourth foul is number 25, Chandler Parsons, his first.
So with 2:32 remaining.
At the line,
Xavier shooting free throws. And McLean goes to the line where he's one of two today. They've only missed one of their free throws, and Florida's missed most of theirs.
I think if you're Florida, you try to get to the half only down 10. And make your adjustments with your transition defense and your toughness around the rim. You can have a chance in the second 20 minutes.
Walker. Well, I don't know how he got that one in there. Somehow the little guy with the left hand, a scoop shot off the glass. Down to 12. McLean lost the handle a little bit as he crossed the lane, and Macklin with a rebound. Well, Jimmy said get it down to 10. They can get it down to 10 or less if they score this trip. Macklin over Frease. 10 it is.
Yep. Brad Frease is not going to elevate. Macklin can get his shot off over him if he takes his time like he just did.
Can they get it to single digits? A stop here and they've got a chance. Crowd is trying to help him out. Holloway trying to break Shipman down in the lane. And offensive foul. Parsons hold his ground. Well, this is just the push that the Gators needed with 1:19 remaining in the half. Another basket here. They're going to be as close as they've been since way back at the 15-minute mark.
And Xavier will carry foul trouble with them into the second period. And they don't have a lot of depth along that front line. And you know Chris Mack knows the same thing.
Walker thought about a three. Instead feeds it inside. Tyus. And it's down to 8.
A much stronger move out of Tyus. They were trying to play finesse basketball about the first 15 minutes. Now they've gone with some toughness around the rim.
Nice run by the Gators right here. We're under a minute. Lyons all the way across the lane and nobody cut him off. Nice drive by Mark Lyons, a redshirt freshman.
Florida has missed, Brad, on 6 or 7 prime opportunities to draw a charge in this game.
If you want a big shot to end a half or a game, you think about Chandler Parsons, who's hit a couple of game winners. There's about a 5-second difference, shot clock and game clock. Walker drives, stops, Boynton for a triple.
Got it!
Pull up 3. Florida might have one more shot. Nope, not quite. But they do cut a big lead. Down to 7. Chandler Parsons almost hit one even though the clock had expired. He put it up from about 70 and it almost went.
At one point, it was a 6 versus 11 seed.
Yeah.
Then it got to a 7 versus 10. Now it's back to 8 versus 9 for the second half.
And it's 40-33. Ryan and the guys in the UPS halftime report coming up.
Hey.
It's the SEC on ESPN. All part of Rivalry Week, presented by Cisco. And this is a non-conference game that has a nice feel to it, 40-33. I guess it has a better feel if you're a Musketeer fan from the A-10. Brad Nessler, Jimmy Dykes back with you. It does have the feel of a tournament game, though, despite the fact it's a non-league encounter. And Florida, 17-8 finish, Jimmy, at the end of the first half, helped their cause. But it was really all Xavier in the first 20.
Well, Xavier played like men, didn't they?
Yeah.
Think about this. Xavier missed 16 shots in the first half. They went and got nine of those off the offensive glass. Their physical strength, Brad, Florida has not handled well so far in this ball game, and it primarily has been Jason Love. He's 7 out of 8 from the floor. He has 14 points and 5 rebounds. And think about this. Big Cat only played 10 minutes because of foul trouble. 14 points in 10 minutes, about as good of a 10-minute performance on the road as you and I have seen all year.
He has been superb on the inside, and Tyus and Macklin haven't been able to handle him. As we take a look at our Cisco game track, 14 points and 5 rebounds. Xavier 26 in the paint, but Florida had the nice run at the end. As Jimmy said, they could get it to 10, they'd be happy. I think they're pretty happy with 7, and they've got the ball to start the second half. Alex Tyus right in front of us will inbound to Chandler Parsons. You and I talked during the break at halftime, and I said to you, will we see Chandler Parsons playing more of the point? Well, we just saw him play the point and got it down to Macklin. And it's down to a 5-point lead.
And the other thing we talk about some good stuff off the air, by the way.
Actually, we do.
Is how quickly will Florida go at Jason Love and try to make him pick up his third foul? They went right at him.
Here he is offensively. Macklin on his hip. Left hand, got it. Picked up where he left off.
He is so good, again, with either soft hand around that rim. He has a really good second move when you take away his primary push.
Parsons trying to get it to Tyus, and they'll have to bring it back out to Walker. And he had his three-pointer blocked, but it comes free to him on a loose ball. And now Macklin, hook shot, missed it on the baseline. Whose ball? It is Florida's. Last touch by Love.
First two possessions of the half, Florida goes inside, trying to get Jason Love to pick up a third foul.
You know, Vernon Macklin, a couple of games ago against Mississippi State, just exploded in the first 4 minutes of a second half. Maybe they are hoping he would do something like that here. Walker feeds Tyus on the baseline. Powers his way in. Parsons keeps it alive. Didn't get a foul call, and it looked like maybe McLean got it.
And Brad, he didn't get the foul call because, again, he tried to finesse it inside against Xavier, and that ain't going to work.
They're too strong. Lyons clangs a three. Battle for the rebound. One also by Xavier, and Love tips it once, tips it twice. Out of bounds to who, Joe Lynch? Is going to say still Xavier ball.
One thing I really admire about Jason Love, he's an adult. They have had zero academic or off-the-floor issues with this big kid in the 4 years that he's been there. Very mature, the kind of guy that every coach would love to have.
Out of Philadelphia, going through Parsons for 20. Beg your pardon, 18.
Brad, he has not scored above the rim yet. It's all power angles from 31.
And a whistle and a foul. Holloway picks up his second foul. There's the RPIs that we were talking about earlier.
Well, Florida's will drop when you look at the remaining schedule at Ole Miss, Tennessee in this building, Vanderbilt in this building, at Kentucky. A game of major importance in mid-February in the eyes of the selection committee. They will zero in on this one for both clubs.
Walker, baseline jumpers, an air ball pulled out of midair by McLean. Holloway, offensive foul. He's done that about four times, and they finally caught him. He's pushing off while he's dribbling, and that's his third foul. So you talked about the foul trouble earlier. They had enough of it at halftime, and now they've got more.
And, Brad, sometimes Holloway has to push off a little bit because he's not a jet. He's more of a power driver. That time he took the ball in the teeth of the defense with really nothing in mind.
I spend most of my game shoving you over here.
With nothing in mind.
That's right. I don't have the Jets. Boynton, three. Macklin tried to keep it alive and did, because last touch by Xavier.
I'm Florida. I try to score right here off the out of bounds. Again, out of conference play in mid-February, you can get a sneaky 2 points if you execute.
Whoa, and Lions just shoved Walker down. So the fouls are piling up a little bit on Xavier. Oh, he just lost his balance. Yep. He got tripped over Tyus a little bit and couldn't control it. Picks up the foul. Parsons gets it to Macklin, who asked for it, received, and kicks it back outside. Now he gets it back. Trying to get around Love, and that's not working. Boynton for three. Got it. Kenny Boynton's had a couple of big field goals. In fact, he only has two. They've both been three-pointers.
A great pass by Macklin, because Love had thrown up a wall that Macklin couldn't move. Macklin didn't get impatient, though, and looked to the weak side.
Down to six, the Xavier lead. Muscle inside, getting his own rebound, was McLean, and then he's fouled.
Brad, watch Macklin right here. He picks up his dribble, and he looks opposite immediately. He doesn't waste time by fumbling around with a strong side of the floor. His eyes lock into Boynton, and Boynton shoots it at the top of his jump. When he does that, he can stroke it.
You mentioned, even with the troubles that Boynton and Walker have been having in recent games, at this point right now, they have hit 54 of the last 67 three-point shots for Florida. That was almost an air ball. Walker's got Boynton in the open court. Timeout, Xavier.
A great look ahead. From a sophomore to a freshman, they've logged a lot of minutes, maybe starting to pay off.
Some of the reptilians in attendance at the O-Dome, 44-40. They have reason to scream now, because this is as close as it's been since it was 11-8 in the first half. Take a look at Florida's resume, Jimmy. 17-7, 6-4 coming in. Problem is some bad losses in the non-conference strength of schedule, I guess.
Well, it is. The Michigan State win obviously has a lot of shelf life. The Florida State win as well. I don't always buy into that number, that 204 right there, until you really look at it, because here they've played Florida State, Michigan State, Syracuse, and at NC State. So sometimes that number's a little misleading, and the selection committee, they don't want to pay attention to that number. They get it out and go right down the line. Who did you play? Who did you beat? Where was the game? But certainly Florida needs another high-quality win, and this is a chance for one.
And the way Xavier played, especially in that first half, they look capable of beating anybody on a given night, as Crawford knocks down his first three of the game. He'd been kind of quiet. 9 points for him. Boynton's had a hot hand from three-point land in the second half. Tyus, baseline jumper. Snatched down by McLean. Lions is going to take a deep one.
That's a bad shot. He's shooting 18% in conference play. A no-pass three-point shot.
Macklin barely got the catch from Walker, but he got the hook shot in. Macklin with 4.5, 8 for the game. Musketeers by 5.
I think the next dead ball, you'll see Lions getting to go and sit down by Chris Mack from that last three-pointer that he fired up.
Turnaround jumper, no good, but McLean again on the glass. And now, three-pointer rattles out again. Love is there with a left hand. Florida comes out of the pile and escaped any further damage after three missed shots by Xavier. Parsons feeds inside to Macklin as he faked the three-pointer. Macklin still can't get it to go. Tyus, can he do it? Parsons. Everybody up on the glass trying to get it in the dish. No luck on any of those. But Xavier by five with 14:32 to go. Don't forget, coming up tonight from Rupp Arena in Lexington, the Cats and the Vols will have at it. John Calipari's got the Wildcats, the number two team in the country. Bruce Pearl and the high-flying Tennessee Volunteers. All gets underway at 9 o'clock following game day. And that should be a dandy. Take a look at the SEC East. Kentucky is the top club. Tennessee trying to get closer. Vandy already won today. That's why this game for Florida is so important. They can get their seventh win. How about the best 11 and 12 team in basketball? The Georgia Bulldogs beat South Carolina today at Stegman Coliseum. They continue to beat people they're not supposed to beat, especially at home.
They have five or six high-quality wins, yeah. Georgia does. You don't want to match up with those dudes in that SEC tournament in that first round.
Well, Florida is doing themselves no favors from the free throw line tonight. They came in shooting about 70% as a team. They are 7 of 14.
Brad, they missed a ton of them at South Carolina on Wednesday as well on the road.
Parsons got the second. Irving Walker with a little one-man pressure on Holloway. Four-point game. Xavier has led virtually throughout. Florida's only lead was at 6-5 in the early going. Here's been the man of the hour, Love. He has to kick it back outside. 10 on the shot clock. Florida doing a pretty good job defensively. Holloway on the dribble. Double team in the corner. And Werner with a steal. Excellent defense by Florida. And a foul on Love, and that's three on the big fella.
A big defensive stop by Florida coming out of the timeout. And then to follow it up with a stop of the breaks by Warner, and Love runs over him.
Holloway's got three fouls. Jackson's got three. Love's got three. Something we'll have to watch. Werner. Parsons with a catch. And the follow. Down to two.
You would love to be able to throw it inside right now, Brad, if you're Xavier, and at least get fouled and take the crowd out of the game for a few seconds. Can they do it?
Freeze is asking for it. They don't get it to him. And then an off-balance shot, and not a good one. And Macklin snatches it down. Florida can tie or lead. Lob to Parsons. Got it! Down by 16 in the first half, by 7 at halftime, and all of a sudden we're tied.
Brad, is a very important ball game for both Xavier and Florida. Again, they are tracking right now to end up in that NCAA tournament, about an 8, a 9, maybe a 10 seed by Florida right now. You jump out of conference play in mid-February and win a high-quality game like this, the selection committee pays attention. Parsons has been Florida's best rebounder the last two games, and he just got a major offensive board, then runs to the rim in transition, and the O-Dome comes to life.
The guy that was in our star watch for Florida, and he's in there right now, isn't he? 12-3 run for the Gators.
I would still throw it back inside on this possession if you're Xavier. Freeze or McLean are two guys you could throw it to.
Crawford on the dribble, down to 12 on the shot clock again. Again, Florida's defense has picked up the intensity. Jackson thought about a long ball. Crawford's going to have to let fly from way out. Macklin with a rebound. Walker slows it down for the Gators. And now speeds it back up, leaves it. Gators lead with Macklin on a flush. The O-Dome in a frenzy now, as the Gators have chopped their way back to the lead.
Motion offense by Xavier, but you got to move. They're a little stagnant right now.
Frease in close. That silences the crowd momentarily. Tied at 49.
They did not settle for a tough perimeter jump shot or a tough two. They were patient and got Frease freed up at the 10-foot mark.
Parsons threw a double team with a floater. It floated too much. Xavier comes back with a chance to regain the lead. And they do.
Brad, in the first half, Florida, they tried to finesse baskets around the rim. Look at Macklin. No finesse from the big fella.
The SEC on ESPN, tie game, Florida and Xavier at 49. Men's college hoops and rivalry week continues on ESPN tomorrow afternoon. Rick Pitino's Louisville Cardinals heading to the Carrier Dome to take on Coach Boeheim and a number 3 Syracuse Orange. Rivalry week presented by Cisco on ESPN. 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon.
Brad, Louisville, one of those teams with platinum status on Jimmy D's jet over the years. But right now, way deep on that standby list with teams like North Carolina and UConn pleading their case, but we've been on your jet for so many years. It doesn't matter.
No,
what
doesn't
did you
matter.
Do this year has nothing to do about your tradition in the NCAA tournament.
Yes, you do.
You could go on a later flight if you choose to, and we'll give you a little bit of extra money to wait. I don't think so. Crawford at the free throw line. Jason Love back in the lineup for Xavier.
There's pressure on Jordan Crawford to score every game. Holloway and Lyons not really knocking down shots on the perimeter. Crawford has to produce.
This is a different look for Florida, to say the least. Murphy, Werner, Tyus, who's underneath on the feed from Werner, and a foul on Love.
Brad, Florida so good. So good coming out of timeouts the last 3 or 4 possessions. And Tyus right here, and watch him. He gets a back screen by Boynton, who is a shooter. You can't leave Boynton. That's a great design play. And again, what did Florida do on the catch? A strong two-handed through your chin to the rim type play. They weren't doing that the first half.
And Kevin Love, who just came back in, sits right back down. Fourth foul. That is huge. Tyus, and again, free throw stripe has been a disaster for Florida. But they lead by one with 11 to go. Frease wants it, draws a double team. Nice pass down low and a foul on Shipman. Good job by Frease to just wheel around to that double team and throw it as hard as he could down to McLean.
But Frease has really played well now in this game. It's not like when Love goes to the bench that this is the guy that just looks like he can foul.
Right.
He's producing a little bit right now with that size.
They try to lob it into him, and Tyus got a hand on it. Shipman on a breakaway, and the foul is going to go on McLean.
I think Shipman may have had a chance to score and get fouled if he takes it up with two hands. You are not going to score in this ball game trying to finesse stuff around the rim.
Shipman does not get to the free throw line very often. But he's now 10 out of 18 on the year as he hits the first one.
Billy Donovan getting Parsons and Irving Walker and Macklin some minutes of rest. So now Murphy and Shipman and Warner have to hold their own in this game.
And a timeout taken by Xavier. He didn't like, Coach Mack didn't like what was going on out there at all, and he's in everybody's face. .10:29 remaining. Key plays in this second half. First of all, good defense by Florida. The overplay by Werner, and there was a third foul by Love. Then Florida went on a little run. Chandler Parsons in the right place at the right time for a stick back, and then the lob from Walker, and that's what put Florida up 49-47. They're up two right now as well. Macklin throwing one of his down, and it's 52-50.
Brad Xavier, they have very good quality wins at home against Cincinnati, Charlotte, Dayton, Rhode Island. Those are high-quality wins. They don't have that true road win yet on their resume that would bump them up another line or possibly two in the eyes of the selection committee. They have a chance to get one right now in Gainesville.
Florida's going to leave that same lineup in despite the timeout and the break by Xavier. They've got 10 on the shot clock. The Musketeers, Holloway, nice penetration by Holloway. That's his first field goal of the ball game, and it ties things again at 52.
Couple of things working against Xavier. Florida is already in the bonus partner, and Xavier only has one timeout on the road with 10 minutes to go. That's never good.
Boynton for three. In and out. Redford with a rebound. And now Werner with another steal. His steals are going to look pretty good in the scorebook tomorrow. And Billy Donovan wants to talk about it.
I like the timeout, Brad, by Billy Donovan, because he wanted to get Walker back in the ball game and didn't want to waste an offensive possession without having his best offensive players on the floor. The next dead ball is after the 8-minute mark, so he had four timeouts. He uses one to get a good offensive possession right now coming out of the timeout.
Well, the timeout that Coach Mack used, you could just tell that at that point he said, he actually came out and you could read his lips. He said, what are we doing out there? They didn't like what their offense was doing. So a good timeout, I think, by Florida here. Maybe not a great timeout, though, like you said, by Xavier, because they're getting thin on them right now.
In a close ball game like this, you cannot afford to waste a possession. I think Billy Donovan felt like if he didn't take a timeout and get Walker back on the floor, it might be a wasted opportunity. Does the timeout now pay off? This game's going to go down to the wire, and Billy Donovan knows it. Can he get 2 or 3 points off of this timeout? He's been very good so far in this game.
I was going to say, you pointed that out earlier. Coming out of timeouts, they've run set plays, and they have paid off just about every time. Will it happen again? Boynton's going to draw a crowd. Walker leaves it for Tyus. Can't connect underneath, though, and a strong, strong rebound by Jamel McLean.
They got the look they wanted, just couldn't get it to drop.
Frease on the baseline, knocks down the baseline shot, and he's got 10 points.
He has really been a presence with Jason Love on the bench with foul trouble.
Now Florida hadn't had any turnover problems in the second half, but they turned one over there, and a three ball goes. What a swing for Xavier. Dante Jackson's second three-pointer, and all of a sudden, the Musketeers explode out to a 5-point advantage. See, the Gators have an answer now.
Brad, I'm really impressed with the mental and the physical strength of these guys in blue.
Macklin, nice up and under around three. A dozen for Vernon Macklin. Remember, Love on the bench for Xavier with four fouls. And a push. I think it's going to be on Tyus on the inside.
Brad, a nice play by Macklin. Frease is a 7-footer, so you're not going to score over the top of Frease. You have to go around him. And Macklin does a good job of feeling where Frease is. Right now, he feels him and then gets off of him and goes around him. Nice play by 32.
It's like going around a school bus.
It is.
Inbounds play rejected by Tyus. Woo. Andrew Taylor won't try that again soon. Still Xavier ball, though. Having a little trouble getting it in. They got it into the big guy, and he hammered it. 12 for Frease.
The scouting report on Frease is changing before our eyes. He has gotten it done. He has been very active.
Walker misses on a three, and a foul on Parsons, trying to slap the ball out of there. So Xavier, their coach is fired up now because they've responded, and they lead by five with just under 8 minutes to go.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Cisco. Welcome to the Human Network.
59-54. Xavier now in front. Jimmy, take us inside the play with Mr. Frease.
Brad, if you're a big guy defensively on an out-of-bounds play, you cannot lose contact with a guy you're guarding, either physically or with your vision. And watch Maplin right here. He's going to lose contact with Kenny Frease. And as soon as he loses contact, watch what happens. Right now, he has lost contact both physically and with his vision, and Frease rolls right to the rim. That's a breakdown by Maplin and a good read by Frease.
12 for the big fella. Off the Xavier bench.
Boy, if he has a great offseason, which I think the Xavier staff is going to put this guy through a ton of workouts, he will be hard to handle next year as a junior.
Yeah, he's a physical load. Five-point lead for Xavier on the road. With 7.5 minutes to play. McLean gets it out. Crawford for three. Got it. Big shot by Jordan Crawford. It's loaded. Just threw it away in the backcourt. The ball was going one way, and Irving Walker was going the other. An unforced error, just a mental error. Tyus threw it one way. Walker went the other. McLean against Macklin. Mac and Mac on the baseline, and free ball comes out to Xavier. Fresh shot clock.
And I would use a large part of it right now if I'm Xavier. No reason to be in a rush.
They work Crawford around a baseline series of screens. Series of screens. Boynton still trying to stay with him defensively. 10 to shoot. Crawford, deep ball.
The only good thing out of that possession, they took about 33 seconds off the game clock.
Ended up taking that shot from the swamp.
I think this is a must possession for Florida.
Boynton, Macklin inside, is fouled.
Brad, you're just going to see a good screen right here by Taylor, and Crawford's going to work off of it to get a good look. That's a good headhunter screen. McLean was getting ready to set another one. A staggered screen that Crawford works off of and sticks probably the biggest shot so far for Xavier.
And now Macklin going to the free throw line where he hasn't hit one yet. Florida from the stripe has been terrible today. Down to 6 minutes. And the Musketeers by eight. See if they use all the shot clock again. Now they're going to take a quicker one this time. Maybe shouldn't have. Irving Walker trying to shake Lyons. Ooh. Collision inside, off balance shot, but at least it'll get into the free throw line. Lyons picks up his third foul. Jimmy talked about the futility of the free throw stripe against South Carolina. It's worse today, or as bad.
Brad, they're, like you've said, 70% on the year, at least in conference play. It's uncharacteristic for Florida to be missing these men.
This guy doesn't miss many. Irving Walker, who's 10th in the conference in free throw shooting at 78%. He hasn't missed in his three attempts today. Again, Irving didn't start the game after being late to a team meeting, but came in quickly in the first half. And he's got 9 points. Xavier by six. Just under six to go.
Chris Mack trying to get to the last TV timeout of the game before he puts it. Jason Love back in. He's about a minute and a half away from that mark.
Florida trying to pick it up defensively again, see if they can get a stop.
2-3 zone. They better make sure they know where Jackson is.
Three rims out. McLean again, another big rebound, and straight back up with it. And this one goes up and over as Jackson missed. Took a couple and didn't get them. He's checking his follow through still. Werner will inbound to the backcourt, and we'll see Parsons bring it up again for Florida.
Chris Mack spent all week, Brad, trying to get his defense to get back to playing with an edge. And the reason why, he knew going forward in the NCAA tournament, even today, there will be points that we have to get stops. Right now, Xavier's at that part of the game.
Love's back in there with four fouls. See if Florida goes after him. Walker blocked by McLean. Not a good shot by Irving Walker. And on the other end, Love has it knocked away from him by Tyus, or he would have had a breakaway jam.
Chris Mack brings Love in a little earlier than I thought he would. I thought he tried to get to that TV timeout.
Now he wants him to get to the TV timeout without another foul.
Yep.
Ten on the shot clock. Crawford with Shipman on him. Shipman trying to overplay him to not let him get to the paint. Fadeaway jumper isn't going to go. How many offensive rebounds has McLean had today? Wow. Number 22 hitting that glass when his partners are missing shots. Still a six-point game with just over four to go now. Tough cut by Crawford. Off-balance shot, not a great one. Tyus pulls down the miss.
Walker needs to stay under control.
Parsons backpedals, three-pointer. Got it! When you want a big shot, seems like number 25's the guy. Two game winners this year. From the junior out of Castleberry, Florida, and a big three-pointer. Watch him take his time, Jimmy.
And it's a good decision by Walker not to over-penetrate and let the defense swallow him up. He finds Parsons. Parsons with a step back. And Brad, just watching him in the shoot-around today and before the ball game, he has that confident, borderline cocky strut about him right now that somebody on your team has to have when you're in the middle of that February grind. Kind of like how you walked into the building today about an hour and a half before tip. I like that about you.
Little travel trouble. The other 2 million people that saw me at the Atlanta airport today know how I feel. Florida's remaining schedule. At Ole Miss, at Georgia, that won't even be easy. And at Kentucky, the other ones are home.
Well, they have a chance to improve their RPI with the likes of Tennessee, Kentucky, Vandy. None of those are any bigger than this one right now. other than that Kentucky game.
They've worked their way back to within three, the Gators. Drive, and it slapped almost out of his hand. Seven on his shot clock. Frease hook shot is short, and the ball's out of bounds to Florida. 3:13 to go. Xavier 62, Florida 59. All right, Ryan, 62-59, 3:13 to play here. I'm glad this isn't a back-to-back thing because this has been physical, especially in the second half.
Brad, it has a great feel to an NCAA first-round game. It's like Xavier's an 8 seed taking on Florida as a 9 seed, and the winner of this ball game will advance to take on a team like Kentucky or Kansas or Syracuse in 48 hours.
Boynton to try to tie it. And a rebound is Love's. 3 minutes left. Crawford trying to go baseline and take things over, and got the roll and the foul.
Boy, again, the physical strength of Xavier has really impressed me in this game. Look at Crawford go up strong with two hands. He doesn't try to finesse anything around the rim. Xavier has been more consistent in that part of the game than Florida.
But Jordan Crawford, the sophomore out of Detroit, knocks down an old-fashioned three. The lead doubles from the timeout, up to six. Walker draws a lot of navy blue jerseys. Around a Werner pick, backpedals and fires. Didn't get the roll, and Love's got another rebound, so Love with four fouls, but two big rebounds in the last two possessions.
I talked about Xavier in the part of the game that absolutely has to have a stop. Now that goes to the shoulders of Florida. Can they get one?
Jackson fakes the three, cross-courts it as we approach 2 minutes. Don't forget, College Game Day follows us, and then Tennessee and Kentucky from Rupp. And a whistle and a foul on Walker. Florida got down by as many as 16 in the first half. It was 38-22. They cut the lead to 7 at halftime, 40-33. Then went on a nice run of their own and actually had a lead of 52-50. But now it's the Musketeers in command again with just over 2 minutes to go. Here's the best free throw shooter in the A-10 at the line.
Xavier has been strong on the boards, they've been strong with the ball, and they've been strong at the free throw stripe. And all three of those, I think, are attached to mentally how you approach the game. For them to do this on the stripe on the road, very impressive.
You're not kidding. This is not an easy place to play. Florida's 11-2 in here this year. They were 18-2 at the O Dome last year. There have been seasons when they haven't lost at all at home.
Florida's 80-10, Brad, in this building since 2005.
Yeah. Tyus, how many big rebounds is McLean going to get just in the last 5 minutes? Florida sees it slipping away right now. Still 1:35 to go. Crawford, nice move. Yeah.
Extremely well coached is Xavier.
The lead goes back to double digits. Florida takes the timeout. Do they have enough time to do anything about it, though? Now, Crawford, Jimmy said earlier, he's a scorer. Can do it a variety of ways like that.
Brad, he's really tough with that basketball. Look him off this curl. That's a strong, powerful move to the rack. That's 6'4". You know, he can score from all different areas. And boy, about the 7 or 8 minute mark, the old dome was absolutely rocking. And Xavier came out with a lot of poise. They punched back Florida in the nose, around the rim, on both ends of this floor.
We were talking a little bit earlier, we said Crawford's been quiet. He hit back-to-back threes, and all of a sudden he's got 18 points, just about on his average. Florida needs a quick score and a stop and another quick one.
It was 52-52 at the 9-minute mark. And Xavier answered.
Did they ever? Florida with Walker, Werner, Tyus, Parsons, and Morton on the floor. Here's Parsons for three. And the rebound is, this is just like Groundhog's Day. I just keep saying McLean with a rebound. And he's fouled.
The reason why McLean now has 13 rebounds in this game, he's the one guy that goes get and gets rebounds that are 50-50 balls. Everybody else for Xavier, in my opinion, they get the rebounds that are naturally coming to him. This guy goes and snatches them away from other folks.
And that has tied his career high, as a matter of fact, Jimmy Joe, with 13 boards. And the free throw to boots.
Brad, this will be not only a big win for Xavier, but a big win for the A-10. When you look at those top six teams with those RPIs and 40 or better, the A-10 will smile on this win, and it bodes well for that league to get six bids.
And you got to wonder if indeed it holds up the next 69 seconds, how devastating is it going to be for Florida? It's certainly not going to help them, that's for sure.
Florida will shoot the double bonus.
Those are quality teams right there. Only one of them ranked right now, Temple, but that is very misleading. And again, the NCAA Selection Committee, they don't even pay attention to rankings when they get in that room. Your RPI, your strength of schedule, your quality wins. And this is one of those eye-popping out-of-conference wins in mid-February that just jumps off the paper at you.
I'm going to tell you the first thing Billy Donovan's going to say after this loss. We lost it at the free throw line and on the boards.
Same thing Wednesday night from the free throw stripe.
11 out of 23 is not going to cut it. You're not going to win many that way. Full court pressure by Florida. Final 109. And a foul on Boynton. And that'll send, again, Holloway, the guy that they want at the line, right back to it.
Holloway, Brad, was so good right there getting himself open in that press breaker, knowing that he's a close-you-out point guard from the free-throw stripe. And he absolutely just went and got that basketball.
Don't forget, College Game Day follows us. Reese, Digger, Jay, and Hubert be along at Rupp. And then it will erupt with about 24,000 on hand for Kentucky and Tennessee, which ought to be a dandy. And Holloway talked that one in with a minute to go. Xavier up 12. And some of the folks at the O-Dome starting to file out. Irving Walker. Kind of got a pass there from the Xavier defense as he got the layup and then got the foul. Look out. We got players down. We got officials pinned against the sideboards. And it's all good.
Brad, the game clock did not stop under a minute after that last basket. Not that it's going to matter, but it was a good 6-7 seconds went off that game clock with the ball on the baseline. Have to replace that one, won't they, partner?
Yeah, I guess so.
Goes to a minute. Now watch. See, that thing continues to roll right now. And that thing's supposed to stop in the last minute.
Yeah, it was about 5 or 6 seconds, huh, at least. And Holloway missed a couple. That's a rarity. Morton had it stripped, and now Holloway won't miss this one. Final 40 seconds. Florida's going to fall to 17-8. They're going to wish more of their three-pointers had gone and more of their free throws had gone down today.
So
Big, big win for Chris Mack.
Yeah, so impressed with the job that this guy has done as a first-year head coach. When you look at what he had to work with the first day of practice, Jason Love is the most experienced guy, only averaged 6 points last year. But again, because they aggressively schedule and they set the bar high, and he has not changed anything about the DNA of Xavier. They guard their tails off. They value that basketball. And physically, they will wear you out at the rim if you don't meet them.
Look at the double-double this guy had. He's going to be a point shy probably of his career high in scoring, even with that free throw. But a big double-double and a huge first half by Jason Love. Some gigantic rebounds by his teammate Jamal McLean. And then the scoring by Jordan Crawford. And Florida's going to come up short on their home floor for only the third time this year. Good job by the Musketeers of Xavier, the A-10, to come into SEC land in a tough place to play and come away with an impressive win. And I mean very impressive win. 76-64 is the final. Xavier goes to 17-7. Florida falls to 17-8. There's the final buzzer. 76-64 for Chris Mack and his Musketeers. For more on this game, you can tune into ESPN News. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Jimmy Dykes and our crew, Brad Nessler, saying so long from Gainesville, California.